Hey everyone, Morgan here. So today I have a very special collaboration video from Kenny over at The Ugly Tent. Now I'm gonna put all of his information down below, but in this video he's gonna be showing us some tarp shelters. And I'm gonna be taking some of his tips along with some just general tips about how to make a shelter from tarps. And in tomorrow's video, I'm going to be doing some of my own practice with making shelter from tarps. So this weekend is all about tarp shelters. Enjoy.
Hey everybody, it's Kenny with Ugly Tent here on YouTube, and I'm under the same name on other social media platforms, including uglytent.com. First and foremost, I'd like to thank Rogue Preparedness for having me on and collaborating with me on this video. So I'm really excited to be working with Morgan on this collaboration video. She has a lot to offer. Her information is amazing on the social media platforms, on YouTube, on her website. Man, this girl has a lot of good stuff going on. I even have one of her planners that I use. I use it daily. It's a daily planner. I love it, and it helps me stay organized and prepared. So it is an honor and a privilege to be working with her, to be sharing ideas and information. So thank you. So when we were discussing the idea of a collaboration video, I thought, what do I have to offer someone like her? Because she is so knowledgeable in all different areas. You know, she covers survival and bushcraft and tactical and prepared. I mean, she just covers all kinds of stuff. So I thought, what can I offer her? And one of my strong points is the tarp configuration videos. So I wanted to give her some of my best tarp configuration video ideas for her to look at and for her to practice and maybe challenge her to do some of these. So I wanted to start off with the first one is a solo, just your basic solo, my favorite solo survival shelter, and that's the plow point wedge. It's called the wedge, the plow point wedge, the plow point. It's just taking a small, either a 5x7 tarp or a poncho and using it to make an emergency shelter. And you can do this so many different ways. You can tie it off to a tree, you can use a ridge line, you can use a bipod, you could use a tripod. There's all kinds of different ways to do this, but to me that's the first place to start. When you're learning tarp configurations or emergency shelters, you need to start with the plow point wedge. There are so many advantages to it. You're maximizing your coverage with that, and it's good for getting out of the weather. It's good for keeping the warmth, creating that microclimate, you know, keeping the warmth inside your shelter with the fire next to it. There's just a lot of advantages to it. So if you're just starting out with the shelters, survivor shelters, this is the place to start, in my opinion. The second one I recommend is using the same 5x7 tarp or poncho or even a bigger tarp to do a lean-to. Now this is just a basic, a lean-to shelter is great for keeping the wind off your back, getting out of the weather for a short period. It does have its disadvantages because it's open on one side, and if you're in a really bad weather, then you're not protected on all sides. But the lean-to, most people have that down. That's probably the first one most people go to, is the lean-to, but that is a very important shelter to learn. And it works for groups too. It works not just for solo, but if you've got a bigger tarp, it's great for a small group. So the third one I recommend is the star configuration shelter. For me, this is one of my favorites for overnight camping. This is great for a small group. If you take a bigger tarp, a 10x10 or a 10x13, and you stake in the back corners, and then you come in on your front corners, you go in about a step, let's see, about a foot and a half in, and stake down those corners, and crawl inside underneath, and put a stick or a trekking pole in the middle, and prop up the middle, you've got a really nice configuration there, really nice shelter for, again, for one person and their gear, or for multiple people. This creates a lot of coverage. This is almost like a tent. This is a great shelter to learn for. I use it as an example in my search and rescue team. This is a great shelter for two people. You know, this is something that you can pitch up in no time at all. And you're basically, once you peg in your corners and you crawl underneath, you're out of the elements. You're under the shelter. So put your stick up and start working from there, and you're covered. It doesn't take long at all to set this up. And if you go a step farther, put up a ridge line and then tie your center point off to the ridge line, or tie the center point to a tree, then you eliminate the need for the pole or the support in the middle of the shelter, and you've got even more room. So that's the other thing I recommend, is practicing with the star configuration, is to practice setting it up both ways. So the fourth configuration that I recommend is practicing the Forester tarp shelter, and that is taking using the tripod with the support pole being the longer pole. It's a form of a wedge, but you've got the doors on it. So now you've got complete coverage, just covers you all the way around. It looks really cool. It's kind of got a teepee look to it. Very sturdy, very stable. In a windstorm or something like that, it's gonna hold up really well because you've got so many points that it's tied to and staked down. It's a great configuration. It's more an advanced configuration. If you've never done tarp configurations before, start with those other ones before. Get your basics down and then move on to this one. This one's a good challenge for you. And the last but not least is the fifth tarp configuration that I recommend, and that is the Adirondack style tarp configuration. And again, this is more of an advanced configuration. It's kind of a lean-to because it's got a flat side. And then the top comes out and makes a canopy. And this is great for camping under, especially when you got a big tarp and the weather's bad. This is a great opportunity to maximize your tarp and protect yourself and keep yourself dry. But with the Adirondack style tarp configuration, and I say style because this is not a true Adirondack tarp. It is a variation of this configuration, and what it does is allows you to cook underneath it or close to it. You have a fire close to your shelter. It allows you to gather water. I've used it to gather water while it's raining off the tarp. It allows you to do other things. So even though it's raining outside, whether you're inconvenient camping or whether you're in a scenario where you're trying to stay out of the weather, this gives you an opportunity to make the most of your evening, of your night, and stay dry. Now, this is not the end-all to the tarp configurations. There are hundreds of tarp configurations. I'm really amazed by the posts and this information I see, whether somebody comes up with a new tarp configuration, or I see one I've never seen before. I'm like, holy cow, what is that? I'd like to try that. So, you know, this is not the only way to do things, but this is a good place to start for yourself or for Morgan or whoever's learning to whoever wants to learn the tarp configurations. These are the ones that I recommend because I've used them. I've spent time camping under them. You know, I found the ones that work, some that don't work. You know, I've had some fails too, but that's how you learn. And that's what I recommend to you, is get out there with your gear, practice with it, set these up, mess around with them, get familiar with them, and find out what you like. So thanks for watching. Thank you, Morgan, for having me on. I really appreciate it. And I'm going to end with what you say: conquer tomorrow by preparing today.
Thank you so much, Kenny, for joining us here on Rogue Preparedness. Be sure that you guys go and check out Kenny on his channel and social media channels. He is very active in the outdoor community. He's got great content I know that you're going to love. Thank you all so much for watching. Conquer tomorrow by preparing today. Talk to y'all tomorrow. Bye.